Everyone, today the topic is how to get job in the airlines industry. Myself, N. Pooja Shravan, HR Manager, Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. Airlines typically require workers for a multitude of diverse positions, so it's very likely that you'll be able to find jobs in this field. Because of the wide variety of jobs in the airlines, the hiring process and the job requirements will differ. There are, however, a few elements that will remain pretty constant in your search for an airline job. Meeting the requirements. Get a proper education. It is a basic element for this job. There are a huge number of jobs in the airline industry, all of which requires different education and training. The level of education you'll need will depend on which position you are looking for. Below are some of the common airline jobs and the level of education required. Flight attendant. Being a flight attendant typically only requires a high school diploma. If you didn't finish high school, the GED is also an acceptable level of education. Air traffic controller. This job requires either a bachelor's degree, at least 3 years of responsible work experience. Any work experience is typically applicable as long as you can demonstrate that you performed competently. After that, you'll enter a FAA Academy for education on air traffic controlling. Technicians. There are a variety of technicians who work for airlines with different specialties. These jobs usually require at least a bachelor's degree in engineering or a related field and might require further post-graduation work. You'll also have to pass a certification test to get a job with an airline. Pilots. Pilots need extensive education and training. You'll need at least a bachelor's degree to be eligible for the job. Of course, you'll need to know how to fly a plane. So it would help if you already have a pilot's license before starting the college. They'll also need to attend an FAA certified flight schools for a proper training to fly commercially. Meet the physical requirements. Some airline jobs have physical requirements. These are to ensure that planes are operated safely. Vision requirements. Pilots, flight attendants, and air traffic controllers must have 20/20 vision or have corrective eyewear that brings their vision to 20/20. Height and weight requirements. Flight attendant typically must be between 6.3. But this varies between airlines. There is no weight requirement, but they must be able to easily walk up and down the aisles of the aircraft. Strength requirements. Flight attendants will probably have to lift bags into overhead cabins. As such, some airlines set strength requirements, being able to lift around 70 pounds is a typical requirement. Language requirement. Most airline positions require you to speak, read English proficiently. Citizenship. All airline jobs in the US requires you to be able to show proof of being able to work in US. Medical requirements. Most airlines jobs will require you to pass a medical exam to make sure you are healthy enough to perform your job. Pilots typically have to examine every 6 months to ensure they are capable of operating a plane. Age requirements. Most airline jobs will require you to be at least 18. If your job requires you to attend the FAA Academy, you must enroll before you turn 31. Pass a security test. Like most employers, airlines will conduct a background check of applicant. This will typically be most extensive than the normal background check. There are a number of offenses that could cause concern for airlines. Click in the description for the complete list of offenses that the FAA will look for when performing a background check. Either have a clean record or be prepared to explain anything that may come up on your background check. Browse job postings for airline jobs. You'll be able to locate all kinds of airline jobs on the internet. There are numerous ways you can find them. If you want to work for a particular airline, try to check their websites. There are different tabs for the jobs, like job, employment, career opportunity, where you can find the job openings or vacancy. If you can't find anything on the homepage, try typing in the airline's name and job into the internet search engine. Jobs are also posted in the most general sites, so browse these sites as well. Contact airlines directly. If you aren't able to find any job browsing the internet, you could try contacting airlines directly. Sometimes there are job openings that aren't posted yet. If you are lucky enough, you might come across some of these jobs by inquiring the airlines. Try either calling or mailing the HR department of specific airlines and inquiring about their job openings. Put your resume and cover letter together. Whenever you are applying for a job, you'll need a resume and cover letter. In many ways, preparing these documents for an airline position is just like preparing one for any other jobs. There are a few things you might want to emphasize. However, depending on the job you are looking for, rewrite the cover letter and make a resume for a general tips on preparing your resume and cover letter. For a flight attendant position, you want to emphasize any customer service experience you have done. Flight attendants spend most of their time helping passengers, so any experience you have working with the general public will definitely be valuable. Example, include the working as a cashier or a receptionist, which will definitely help you to get a flight attendant position. For any kind of technician position, you'll want to emphasize jobs and internships you have done that requires electrical and engineering skills. Always read job ads carefully and put keywords from the posting in your cover letters. For example, it's a common for a posting to look for highly motivated candidates. In this case, explain in your cover letter that how you are highly motivated. This shows that you have taken the time to read the posting and put together a good cover letter. Basically, use phrases and words from the job posting to demonstrate why you are a good candidate. Preparing for interview. If you have done the good job in your cover letter and resume, you'll progress to the interview stage of the job. And particularly, the interview process will vary depending on which job you are going for. A flight attendant may get the job after only a quick meeting, while a pilot probably requires several interviews and tests. It is important to follow whatever process the airline uses to interview job candidates. Re-prepare for a job interview from the tips to get a proper interview. You'll get many tips, enormous tips in different websites and through different videos. So just go through with all the tips and tricks. Conduct yourself appropriately during the interview. No matter what position you're applying for, you should always maintain a polite and professional demeanor during the job interview. Many positions in airlines like pilot, technician, and air traffic controller are directly responsible for purchasing safety. Accordingly, interviewer will want to hire competent and serious individual for jobs. Always remember to dress appropriately for an interview. Appropriate dress may vary depending on what job you are applying for. A good general rule is to dress a step up from what you would wear every day to work. Many airline positions, including flight attendant and pilot, will require to interact with the airline customers. As such, you should always maintain a friendly demeanor to demonstrate that you are the right candidate. There really is no way to anticipate the type of questions you'll get during the interview. Generally, you should be prepared to talk about your strengths and have a few stories ready to tell the demonstrate about your competency and responsibilities. What are the jobs available in the airline industry? Airline jobs. On airline jobs, Finder, we break down many different kind of airline career. Each of the following types of airline jobs is discussed in a greater detail in our free member session. Flight attendant job. The main responsibility of flight attendant is to make sure passengers are safe. Next, they must provide great customer service. Flight attendants makes up almost 20% of the 515,000 employees that comprise the aviation workforce. Do you love to travel? The job might be for you. Airline administrative support. Every airline, big and small, needs administrative support staff to keep the office running smoothly. These positions include secretaries, data entry workers, receptionists, communication, and PR specialists. For those who work in a human resource department who handle and oversee the hiring, labor relation issues, training and termination of employee. Operations agents, also known as an airline operator agents. The cargo agent needs a great communication skills for receiving and transmitting information from and to pilots, ground crews, and other personnel. The operation agent must be able to prioritize a large number of projects and tasks when flights are overbooked. Agents must take decision to rectify the situation in a way that will not negatively impact the schedule. Avionic technicians specialize in working on electronic systems of airlines. Avionic electrician jobs involve troubleshooting, repairing, and replacing and installing aviation equipment. Calibration of the equipment may also be required. Regional sales manager. The airline district sales manager oversees all the districts and reservations and ticket sales offices. The sales representative in the district sales representative promotes their airlines in an effort to sell cargo space and plane tickets. Flight dispatcher are responsible for ensuring the safety of an aircraft flights. This includes preparing a flight plan, which is detailed schedule of destination layouts, expected fuel consumption, winds aloft, weather, altitude, compression bearing, and alternate destination in case of problems. Ground and airport station attendant. This position has many names: airlines informational representative, ground attendant, station attendant, special attendant coordinator, or airport informational representative. Regardless of the title, the main responsibility is to assist passengers in a terminal way with general questions regarding directions, terminals services, or arranging wheelchair access. Aviation meteorologist. Aviation meteorologists provide weather information to airline flights dispatcher and pilots. They must determine current and forecasted weather condition for all altitude, including the direction and speed of the wind, cloud cover, and precipitation. Passenger service agent. Passenger service agent, some of the same responsibilities as those in the station agent jobs, but they are focused on working passengers, not aircrafts. Their duties include issuing refunds of passengers, computing fares, preparing and selling tickets, collecting charges for excess baggages, checking baggages, and providing travel information. Ramp planner. An airline ramp planner is responsible for knowing the arrival and departure time for each of the airline's aircraft at their job. He or she coordinates variety of departments or contracted companies that must perform various tasks on the aircraft before it can depart for the next flight. Reservation sales agent. Reservation sales agent provide travel information over the telephone to the customer of the airlines. Typically, this information includes trip planning, car rental, seat availability, fare information schedule, tours, meal, and other information relevant to the customer's flight plan. Although internet reservations have skyrocketed, airlines still utilize reservation sales agents. Sales representative. Airline sales representative helps generate business of the airlines. They promote their airline to business. Crew schedule coordinator. Air crew schedule coordinator are responsible for staffing of air crew and ground support to keep flights on schedule. If weather or mechanical difficulties delay a flight, it is crew scheduler responsibility to make sure schedule adjustments are made so that traveler arrives at the destination on time. Airline station agent. The most important duty of the station agent or district operator manager is to ensure that the overall operation of the given airline at an airport. This encompasses both flight and ground support operations and involves coordinating flight crew, cargo crew, baggage crew, ground crew, and the information that must be communicated among all these teams. Airline tickets agent. Ticket agent work at an airline tickets or a baggage counter. They greet customers when they arrive at the airport. They check in luggage and make seats assignments. They also handle airline ticket sales, reservation change, and provide information on the reservation on the aircraft boarding. Airline flight instructor. Airline flight instructor provides recurrent training for the airline pilots. Airline flight instructor may be senior pilot who fly for airlines. Aviation attorney. Aviation attorney specialized in aviation related cases in commercial or general aviation for individual government agencies or companies. Aviation attorneys represent airlines or another government. Some aviation attorney work for FAA while other may be on staff or on retainer by large corporations who own aircraft or deal with the aircrafts. For each type of jobs profile in our member section, there is a description, pay detail and educational requirements. You won't want to miss our interviews with industry veterans either. Their insights are invaluable. There is a reference. You can go through with the reference through this link. The most successful female entrepreneurs of India. You can go through with this book. It is really useful for the upcoming female entrepreneurs. And this is the perfect book for the pilot's career guide. These are some of the books which you can go through, which you can refer. This is the brochure. Looking for a co-founder, you can get the detail. Thank you so much.